First, you sexually and physically assault us. Then you harass and intimidate us by lodging false complaints against us. And all of this is somehow justified just because we are JNU students? We were protesting against sexual harassment. Is that a wrong thing to do? When the photo was taken, we had already been there for 20, 25, 30 minutes. The police had already water cannoned us thrice, and it was towards the end. Before that, there were no female police under the barricades, at least not near me. So we were being manhandled by male police. So at that point, all the female police came and they were very politely asking to us to, you know, just move back. And we were also, you know, talking to them very politely, and suddenly they started beating us up and started tearing my clothes. And you know, at that point, I could hear them say, like, Kapde, Phaado, and etc. You know, I could not actually believe it. It was pretty shocking. We were taken to a police station in a bus, eight of us girls. And in the police station, first of all, though, they tried to, you know, give us clothes because they wanted to take photographs of us, which we did not realize. So this t-shirt apparently, like, you know, Delhi police gave me this t-shirt to because I did not have any clothes on. One officer, I think she's an IAS officer, IPS officer, whatever, she came and started threatening us. Another policewoman in plain clothes. I don't think she's a policewoman actually, because none of the police people told us who she was, and she was wearing plain clothes, and she started saying all kinds of nasty things to us. You know, tumhara munh noch lungi, gala daba dungi, and stuff like that. Since the night that we came back from the march, it has been pretty, I think the first 2 days would be in shock because of what happened to you, the trauma of, you know, the violence that you happened to you and that you saw happening to your friends. And after that, when we realized that we have an FIR on us and, you know, that we have non-bailable charges against us, these are the last few months of the semester. The people who are with me have to write their MPhils, have to write their PhDs and submit. So it was basically a form of harassment and, you know, having an FIR on you. We did not even know what having an FIR on you means, and you know how it will play out in your life, and how it will hurt your careers. You know, we did not know any of that. And apart from that, we know that this is just a fake FIR, and how, you know, they just do these things to intimidate people. So we are not afraid right now to go to jail. But yeah, in the beginning, we were. Most of the people were, you know, trying to give informal support, legal advice, but no one was willing to take our case, fight our case. There were other parties who were involved in this case. For example, the people who organized the march, the JNU TA, the JNU SU, you know, they called for the march. They were the ones. This is the first time I'm saying this on, you know, on to openly that. You know, that the fact that they were the ones who organized the march, and we thought that they had the permission for the march, and whatever happened to us, it's also at some level their responsibility to come forward and help us, you know, which they did not, you know, and that really demotivated us and, you know, scared us that, you know, how if they are not trying to help us, then how do we get help? Thank you. मेरा सरकार से सिर्फ एक सवाल है, आप लड़कियों को क्या मैसेज देना चाह रहे हैं? कि वो सवाल ना करें, अपना मुंह बंद रखें, सड़कों पे उतरना बंद करें? क्योंकि जो हमारे साथ हो रहा है उससे तो यही दिख रहा है। तो एटलीस्ट आप नारी शक्ति के नाम पे वोट मांगना तो बंद ही कर दें।
इफ यू लव द क्विंट एंड वांट टू कीप सीइंग मोर ऑफ अस ऑन फेसबुक, क्लिक ऑन फॉलो, देन सी फर्स्ट एंड यू विल नेवर मिस अस ऑन योर टाइमलाइन।